Oh, here.
Ah.
Sids.
Hello. Oh, sorry, yeah.
Hello.
Wind.
Putting in there?
Acceleration.
Okay.
I don't know if you use it on the 7.4, but...
Heavily not, but let's do a hybrid approach.
Operate the 7.4 like a 7.3 classic. Well, yeah. It could possibly go wrong.
What could possibly go wrong?
Righty ho. So, pre-flight checklist, please.
Yes. Yeah. We need to do a briefing first.
Oh, before we do the pre-flight checklist.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So, briefing then.
There's an aid memoir there.
Perfect. Hopefully, I should be able to get most of it. Where did the weather go?
The weather went...
It's not in front of you, is it?
No, that's the performance. Make a question, where has that just magically disappeared to?
975, taxi via Alpha, Ultra Bravo, runway 09. Alpha, Ultra Bravo,
is it? Oh, yeah. I'll print the weather again.
Excellent. Add tap.
522. Sorry.
Did he give us an initial altitude?
Yeah, 3,000.
3,000. Okay.
Yeah.
Last aircraft calling for push. You're staying in your call.
B Crawley 57. One of our other team members, Ralph, did used to have a full-size 737 simulator, which we've flown other events in the past, but not anymore.
So, briefing then, left-hand seat departure runway 09 here at Barbados, Grantley Adams.
Yeah.
Flap 20.
Yeah.
No engine anti-ice, no emergency turn from here.
Yeah.
Highest MSA in the region, 2,600. Any problem straight ahead to 3,000 feet. Keeps us nice and safe. Keeps us within Barbados. I put 25-mile fix round here, just for our situational awareness. Aircraft is serviceable, generally. There's nothing that we really need to be aware of that's going to cause us a problem. I imagine they've done a master reset on any failures in case Benny's left us with any presence since... we've just gone. Weather here, some showers of rain, few CB, so we'll take weather radar for departure.
Yeah.
My side, and you can just keep terrain. When we get down there, again, it's a bit rainy, so we've got enough holding, we've got some holding fuel. Threats then will be the fact that I don't fly the 747.
Yep.
So if I do anything strange, please bring it to my attention.
Oh, that's, I think that operating the sim will just generically, life.
Well, if I do anything really, really stupid, just tell me I'm stupid, as other people would have no hesitation in doing. There's no terrain threats here, really. It's going to be busy airspace. Well, we know about the score with the World Flight stuff, so that's about it. Can you think of any other threats, really, out of here?
I'm sort of awake again now.
Yeah,
so
we're both pretty tired, so we'll put that down as a threat. Taxi out from here. I'm not entirely sure where we are. In front of the terminal would seem to be sensible. We're in the actual terminal proper, so somewhere between stand 9 and stand 13, so push and start to face to the west.
Yeah.
And then all the way down Alpha to Bravo, and then runway 09, 3,000, just under 3,400 metres long, 45 metres wide, nice and long. Once we get out onto the runway, do you want me to go through the emergencies, or are you pretty happy?
No, the usual,
Okay, basically any problems, take it into the air, we'll work out what we're doing, we'll come back into Barbados, or preferably continue if we can. Departure is nice and simple, it's 4-10, it's the RNAV SID for runway 09, it's the Bravo 1 with a Kelso transition, nice and easy, straight ahead to Savox, right turn to Kelso, initial altitude of 3,000 feet up in the window. That was the only thing I was going to check, the Q&H is 1010, that's correct. Okay, so threat, semi out weather, takeoff alternates, don't need that. Taxi route, flap 20.
Yeah, we'll do our critical data in a minute, now the fuel's in,
Okay, run me through the acceleration, just so I'm aware, is it?
flaps 20,000 basically, and okay. then it does the thrust reduction at 5.
Flap and accelerate, that's right there, is it? Or
yeah.
Ground,
yeah,
ground.
Yeah, we
don't need to change or anything.
I'll enter that. We need to come back and do critical data together.
Oh, okay.
So we did skip ahead, but never mind. We'll come back. We'll come back and sort that. Yeah.
All right. Yeah, that's all done. Review, SIDS, radio waves. Okay. Anything you want to add?
No, I'm happy.
Okay. Right.
Critical data then. So, zero fuel weight off of the load sheet. You have got 2328, I assume.
Zero fuel weight off of the load sheet. Which is in here somewhere.
Towards the back, usually. Second last. Oh, actually, I might have. There you go.
I've
appropriated the copy.
Zero fuel weight is 188.6.
That's dry.
Oh, sorry, you're quite correct.
That was close. That was a near miss.
There's a threat there. 232.8.
8, okay. And reserves were 13 off of the flight plan. Were they?
Yes, they're 8 plus 4, 6, I estimated about 13.
30.4, okay. There we go. Right, thrust limit, so I have got a takeoff weight of 272, giving us our extra 2 tonnes.
Yeah, which we've got, what does this say it is? Yeah, okay, yeah, 272.
So, well, I've got 270, yeah, that's pretty close, it's 61.
Yep. Okay, 61 degrees then.
Yeah. And then that will give us the derated takeoff with a climb 1 power.
Yeah.
Yeah. Takeoff, so it's flaps 20 with 1,000 feet acceleration.
Yeah.
Yep.
V1.
139.
Yep.
139. And 149.
9 with a C of G of
19%.
Happy?
Yes.
Good.
As happy
so
as
anyway, the last thing to do is on this we can actually arm LNAV and VNAV.
Yeah. There we go.
Ta-da. Going in the box. Would you like a pre-flight checklist?
Yes, please. Pre-flight checklist.
Inspection security.
It is completed.
Oxygen.
It's tested 100%.
Right, instruments.
Heading 004, 160 feet on the QNH.
Yep, same here. PFD.
V2148, LNAV, VNAV, TOGA, 3000 feet.
Takeoff speed.
139, 149.
ACARS pre-flight. I've done that.
Complete. Yeah.
CDU pre-flight
is complete
and taxi and takeoff briefing
is reviewed.
Excellent. Do you want to speak to the man and see if we can pressurise?
Yeah, so flight, or do I just yell?
So flight, then you can just RT forward to talk to him.
Flight 8 to ground, good evening.
Good evening, ground.
Are we clear to pressurise?
You are clear to pressurise all your systems at your leisure.
Thank you very much. We will pressurise.
Okay. I'll get the APU starting.
Yes, please, if you would.
Cross 142, taxi via Alpha
09 and probably the American A320. Yeah, I missed something in my pre-flight. Why has that not come up? Yep. See. As expected.
Next 2, 3. Oh, seatbelt signs as well. Is that me or you?
But either of us once the fueling was complete.
Oh,
yep.
There we go.
Yep. Okay. Good.
Parking brake. Okay.
I've left Pat 1 on for the aircon because we're in Barbados and it's hot.
Okay, APU on the bus, please. Flight deck to ground.
Hello there, flight deck, ground here.
You can take the ground power away as well, we've finished that.
Okay, no problem. We'll disconnect the ground power.
Right, so the before start checklist, please.
Good guess. Flight deck door.
Is closed and locked.
Passenger sign.
On and on.
Beacon.
Is both.
And transponder.
Is auto, off and auto.
Got it.
I do the push and start thing, don't I?
Yes, you talk to them. Yes. You basically go... You normally would have got clearance, but obviously we swapped so we could get going.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you basically do the radio up until... first taxi instruction.
Yeah.
Where is the ground power? Where's that gone? Is that on PSX?
PSX.net.
Yeah. .net.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
Again, ground services. Top right, closed.
Hello, Speedbird 47 Charlie, that request push and start QNH 1010.
Use that.
Ah.
Sorry.
Habits.
Yep.
Barney Adams Ground, good evening. Speedbird 47 Charlie, request push and start with QNH 1010.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, push and start approved.
Push and start approved, Speedbird 47 Charlie. Excellent. Push and start approved then.
Yeah, face left, I believe.
Yeah, I guess so. For 09, face that way. Right. Flight deck to ground, hello.
Hello, flight deck, ground here.
We're clear to push and start for runway 09 to face west, standing by on the brakes.
Pushing back.
They just need to lift that up there.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
Yeah. Well, we're away.
We are away.
No dramas yet. In that case, we can start.
And hello, flight deck. You're clear to start your engines whenever you want.
Okay, start engines at our discretion. Thank you, Speedbird. Thank you, ground.
Right. Okay.
Start 3 and 4, please.
Oh, look, they've got the doors in man auto and everything.
Oh, look at them flicking away.
They're starting 3 and 4.
So we were supposed to be off at 11:30, so we're 11 minutes. That's not
that's
so bad,
okay,
really.
Yep. Could be worse. We can fix that with a slightly bumped up cruise speed.
Of course, I would never do that in my normal job at all.
No. Don't waste fuel.
No.
No, just remind us, what is your normal job?
I'm a bus driver. I think I mentioned that one or two times.
Hashtag willy waving. Yeah, we should.
I need to drive, don't I? Which way do you want to go?
We want to face that way, please. Yeah. Oh, excellent.
You want to pop the nose cam up for the to Twitch PC is probably the easiest way to do it, and now it's worked.
Yes, thank you, Wales. Willy waving indeed. Oh, we're going to push back onto the runway, I think, but hey ho.
It's quite a big apron. Yeah, stop now would probably be nice.
Yeah.
Stop. This is apron here, definitely, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the runway. Yeah, we've pushed back too far, then we'll push back onto the runway when he's taking off.
Yeah, stop.
Set parking brake, please.
You put your foot on the brakes first.
No, I didn't.
Right, and then listen, when you release the brakes.
Ah.
Steering system removed and steering pin removed.
Start 1 or 2, please. Tiniest of clicks.
Tiniest. Before going,
what do we want? Camera wise,
I would go nose front.
Oh, actually, that worked out pretty well. He's vacating, so a Dreamliner.
But is it nose rear? No, I do apologise.
Hello everybody on the stream, so
please.
Yes, it is a homemade flight simulator. So ask Gary.
Yeah, when we start taxi.
Yeah.
Okay. You just need to centre your rudder and do a flight control do a quick flight control check, but
okay, so forward, aft, left, right, rudders, left, right. There we go.
Lovely. Awesome. There we go. Right.
Before taxi checklist, please.
Before taxi checklist, flight controls.
I checked.
Anti-ice.
Is auto but not required.
Recall.
Is checked.
Right, auto brake.
Is RTO.
BAPS.
20. 39.
Ground crew clearance.
Received.
That is, before taxi check is complete, I'm assuming once he passes left to right, and then your last call, just give a call for, and then we swap the radio.
Okay. Speedbus 47, Charlie, request taxi in sequence, please.
Speedbus 47, Charlie, taxi via Alpha, give way to the Air Canada 78 Discard. Clear of the taxiway, taxi via Alpha, and hold short Bravo, runway 09.
Okay, give way to the 787 and then via Alpha to hold short Bravo 09, Speedbus 47, Charlie. Yeah, down there, like I briefed. Is he really going to stop there?
Yeah.
Might have to drive around him then, yeah. I guess.
And, well, the Virgin that's just vacated the runway has blocked the taxiway. Can he just move forward a bit if he's listening? Just a little bit more, a little bit more.
Maybe he's using default scenery or something.
Affirmative.
Oh, excellent. So once he moves out of the way, we are clear for taxi.
Thank you, much appreciated.
Oh, excellent.
He bears, what does Willy Man drive?
Yeah, that's perfect, thank you, mate.
That'll do. Right, taxi light on, please.
Oh, that was grass. It did look like an extended bit of tarmac, didn't it?
Yeah. Well, that's going to be my excuse.
Yes. I'll just casually go around the back
to drive.
Yeah, just a casual reach around.
Yeah.
Are you happy with the wingtip clearance?
Happy with the what?
The wingtip clearance on this.
Yeah,
side.
Yeah, be fine. Wingtip clearance.
What could go wrong?
Oh, excellent, excellent. Well, I'll look out this window for now.
No,
and
absolutely.
Look at the runway.
Yeah, it's literally just gone past.
Excellent. Right, bit more thrust on then.
Morning, gentlemen.
What failures are set for donations? Well, nothing specific, but, you know, sometimes things happen. And the more donations arrive, tends to increase the likelihood of things happening.
Yeah, it's funny how those two things are inexplicably linked, really, isn't it?
Oh, one thing I forgot to say in the briefing.
Uh-huh.
There is a small issue with Toga that it causes the...
this judder thing.
Yeah, so if you just if you stand them up and then ask me to set thrust, I'll set thrust for you.
Okay, so how do we get the Toga guidance? Do you still press it?
Oh, no, it still gives you the guidance, it's just that Toga on the auto throttle won't engage.
Oh, okay.
That's fine, so I'll just manually set thrust, and then as you get to acceleration altitude, it puts thrust in for you anyway. So.
Good thing. Yeah. All right, well, review then.
Is that doing a wobble? Yeah. It does, it keeps judging.
A little bit, every now and again.
Tower 118.7, thanks, PO47, Charlie.
I assume we're in the queue behind these aircraft that are conveniently parked on the taxiway.
Currently, ground velocity 738 has amended flight plan, ready for push and start. Velocity.
It's lucky, really, there's a queue because we don't have the load sheet or anything yet.
No. Well, there's. I can't see any arrivals for now. Ah. What is that?
Oh, convenient.
Ah, really? It's almost as if they heard us.
Would you like the before
takeoff checklist?
Final load sheet.
Received.
Laps.
R20.
Trim.
Is 6 units, 0 and 0.
Correct. Takeoff briefing.
Up at 3,000 feet. I don't think it's automatic frequency change, and we've discussed the manual thrust setting, so reviewed.
He did say contact departures 1293.
Oh, did he?
Is that 13935 or 325?
12935.
Oh, okay.
And I'm assuming that was fine, was it, Simon?
Yeah.
Lovely. Oh, no, 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 just stop, come back. There we go. Runway speed, Ipa Vinav.
Right, this is the one at 148, Toga Vinav, 3.
You were just, the call for this is just set, so you just quickly check. You've still got a runway, you've got some speed, you've got an Ipa set, and Vinav's armed.
Set.
Cabin report.
It's, we got the ding, didn't we, received.
And transponder, I keep forgetting that.
There's tararing.
Tarar.
Oh,
I'll give him a call. Tower Speedbird 47, Charlie is with you, holding in turn.
Speedbird 47, Charlie, to Tower, g'day. Yeah, Qantas 25, are you with me?
Ah! What is that?
Hello.
That is... Wow! £100 from Wales. We said his name right this time.
Oh,
or,
okay.
Or, sorry, as Anger says, Wales.
Wales.
Hello, Wales.
Thank you, Wales.
Thank you.
At 10 to 7 in the morning as well. Well, that's our time. Wherever you are, it might be a bit different, I guess.
He says, no need to read this out, but we'll read it out anyway. He says he's donated £330 in total. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. That's really
that's
good.
Apt because you're building an A330.
Because I'm building an A330, yeah. Did I mention that I do this for a living? I don't know. Oh, it's the thing that I was trying not to mention.
Oh, dear. If I could do this, other people, please donate. Thank you. Please donate.
That's
everyone.
Right.
That's much appreciated. And Gary, you're my favourite. Just don't tell Benny. I'm going to keep this in my pocket.
I think specifically we should tell Benny.
Yeah, I'm going to keep this in my pocket for when he wakes up. Because when he wakes up, he's particularly angry.
To just sort of place it somewhere strategic where he's going to see it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. For his next flight. Yeah. But we do that.
Perhaps we should photocopy it and just paste it everywhere.
Oh, that's going in there.
Into your pants.
How did you know? Oh, that's a lovely donation to start the day off with. I'm invigorated.
Invigorated. Yeah.
Is that what you say? Is that what you call it?
Yes.
Turn right. Left.
It's nice and easy.
Left.
I like it.
Right.
As you would say, an anti-faff departure.
An anti-faff departure.
That doesn't look very anti-faff.
What, this somewhat offsetting? Well,
not so much that. I was more thinking about the four aircraft that we're behind, but
We did quite well though, I still think.
Yeah.
Still.
How many? I haven't even looked at the plates for where we're going.
But a route data. I'll just get the winds up link while we're sat
here. Oh, thank you. Soccer. What is that? That's the Serious Organised Crime Agency, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what I keep thinking of as well. Oh, look, Clipper 811. Shall we give them the welcome? Oh, yes, please.
Just bacon for me, please.
You are, a hero. For those on the stream who obviously didn't hear because he didn't have a headset on, the word was, would you like bacon and egg?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, please.
Another 209 out to carry with me.
I like the way where I've slept my hair sticking up, but it keeps catching just slightly on the edge of the...
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's like, oh, I'm being touched.
I have this sort of, like... clump of hair that where I was sleeping on the sofa, which was actually very comfortable.
Which one did you pick?
The left sofa. Yeah.
With the lovely padding.
Yeah. Yes. Probably should have taken the right wing, that's more where I sit on the spectrum, not rather than
yes,
the centre.
Yeah.
But Simon, you were well on the right there, weren't you, sir?
Yes.
The helmet... on F star?
Yeah, so 8.30. So we have got a chance here. Of being roughly back on time again.
What was the wind down there? Is it ILS for 08?
I don't know, I never got the wind down there. Well, we're waiting, shall we?
Yeah. Forewarned is forearmed, as they say. We might need to get rid of that.
Right, very good point. Well spotted.
Wales asks, what software are you basing the 330 off? Is it the BBS or are you holding off the Aerosoft? I'm assuming it's neither.
No. The Aerosoft looks very good. The BBS is also okay.
That's diplomatic.
We'll leave it at that. I, for my sins, think it's probably a good idea because I have a lot of free time during the winter. I'm a pilot. I don't know if I mentioned that. We don't fly so much during the winter. Hashtag Willy Waving. I had this crazy idea. I might try and write my own software, actually. But saying that, in the interim, there's a piece of software out there called Jehell. Jeehell. And there's another guy who's flying on World Flight in the moment with a 337. That's what he's using. And the advantage of that is it's freeware. Completely free. It's designed for 320. That's the only problem. So things like the electric systems, the hydraulic systems are subtly different. I think at the stage that the sim will be in, it won't make too much difference. When we start going down the nitty gritty of get the sort of functionality that we've got in this sim, then hopefully there will be something around, or I might have continued to write my own software. The advantage is if you can write your own software, as time consuming it is, you can add whatever features you want in whatever timescales you wish. So things like all the niceties that we have in here, like the BAA cars and being able to control the Twitch controls from here, you could put functionality like that in. Saying that, I am tempted to buy a real MCDU, and I don't think I'd be able to put that sort of functionality into a real device because it doesn't have it on the real aircraft. And that road is also fraught with danger as well. It's not very easy to interface real avionics. I mean, how long did it take for you to get this?
A long time.
Yeah.
What is that aircraft at the hold there?
That is an Egypt Air 321, maybe? Oh, it was.
Was. Hi.
Bye then. And this is...
I'll be back in 30 seconds.
Delta?
Delta 209, I reckon.
Oh, no, that's a Delta Airbus. Oh, there's the Egypt Air. It's come back. Oh, it's a bit more recognisable now.
Do you reckon he saw us on the stream and realised he didn't look like an Egypt Air?
And he's reloaded. Is that the model matching that's done that there?
I think he's just changed his... looks like an Egypt Air now.
But we're number four for departure.
Yeah. So your question there, by the way, about... We might be able to pull forward a bit. Yeah. I don't know. Your question about weather.
Yeah.
There is no wind there.
Okay,
but it does say they're expecting ILS approach from 08.
Okay.
The TAF does show that there's going to be some CBs rolling in.
Yeah, I saw that.
He knows to look for these things.
Yep.
Yeah.
Egypt Air 524, you should be lining up now, and I'll give you a take off here shortly. Yeah, we got an aircraft on a 13 mile final, so we should be able to get a couple of you guys out, so as long as we're nice and efficient.
When we talk about Willy Waving hashtag, when we plan where your eye point is when you're coming down the ILS or down the approach, sometimes there'll be like a smudge on the glass or like a dead fly or something. If you keep that, because that's fixed point, you're supposed to keep that on the threshold, and you can see if the threshold moves in relation to that mark, you can tell what your left, right, centre line.
Hashtag ultimate realism.
Ultimate realism.
Hashtag dead fly.
Yeah. What in his effect, but probably Benny's dirty thumbprint has just added to the realism.
Well, it was.
Hello, Egypt Air. Hello, Sim HD1. Egypt Air's on the chat. Hello.
Ah, hello. You've just departed then, I take it.
Oh, hello from Egypt Air. Hello, Sim HD1.
Runway 09. Line up and wait. Today, Channel 1471, established runway 09. Channel 1471, how are you? Continue approach. Going to try and get a couple of aircraft down ahead of you.
Well, so when you say not notice the difference between the two, is that between the 320 and the 330, or
Sorry, say that again?
Yeah.
Wales, we've just discussed the we did an FMC failure last night, and if I'm honest, I'm very tired.
Yeah,
it's probably
it was quite tiring.
Yeah, but we do have a little plan, a small plan of what might happen.
Yes.
Yeah, because this 747 is very unreliable.
Yeah, it's funny the amount of technical problems that we've had in our journey. We're only halfway round.
Exactly.
Is he going to go?
Just out of interest.
Yeah.
Someone dimmed the panel light on the left-hand side.
Up.
Yes, they have.
Yes, they have.
I was trying to work out. I was like, oh dear, what's broken?
The Wales, yeah. I mean, the difference in the two in the flight deck is going to be between the 320 and the 330 is very, very, as you say, very minimal.
Yeah.
By design, because actually you can fly both on. Pretty much, I think there's some differences training, I would presume, but
they have a CCQ, which is called a cross something qualification, cross cockpit qualification. Maybe I'm not entirely sure, which allows you to fly both types, which is what operators like Thomas Cook do. I don't know if some of the big American ones do that as well, but it's better for crew flexibility and scheduling and things like that. And actually, from a pilot's point of view, when we're talking about the software we would run an Airbus sim on, you wouldn't notice a difference until you started getting into the technical failures. So things like a hydraulic failure on the 320 might have different ramifications compared to the 330. 330's got a lot more system redundancy because it's built with ETOPS in mind.
But I suppose with it being an Airbus, it doesn't present those differences to the crew very much.
Not as much. It's just a case of follow what it says on ECAM.
Yeah.
Both agree and then just clear it off. So it's just different push buttons up here on the overhead.
Gary.
Hello.
Where do I find the instructor station on here?
See where you've got the left hat. Right. The big C for chatty.
Oh,
yeah, the left of it.
Yeah.
Click that.
That was a hell of a touchdown.
Oh no, click it again.
Yeah.
One more.
Oh yes.
The one to the right of chatty. Hit the escape key on the keyboard. You have won.
Thanking you.
We must be next.
Lighting up and wait, runway 09, 47 Charlie.
Alright, clear on. Well, there's one to vacate on the left. Did we do the before takeoff checklist?
Yes, we did.
Oh, excellent.
Ground 121.9.
What has happened here?
Vacate on echo, contact ground 1219, ground 1471.
Somehow the... There we are.
Clear for takeoff runway 09,
clear for takeoff runway 09, clear for
47
Charlie.
Right, you ready?
Yeah, and remember I'm setting the thrust,
yeah.
As you say set thrust.
So, stand them up.
Growly Tower, velocity 738
and
Bravo
holding
point runway 09.
Set thrust.
Velocity 738, and speed for 47 Charlie, just confirm, clear for takeoff.
Thank you.
Yeah, we're rolling now, 47 Charlie. Plus set.
Yes.
It's alright.
80 knots.
Checked.
Bus C738, runway 09, line up and wait. Line up and wait for C738.
Rotate. positive, right?
Gear up, please.
Gear up.
Oh, there's no massive clunk when you do the trim.
No. Mate, no worries, that was great, thanks. 47 Charlie, bye-bye. Thrust is in now.
Checked.
Departures, hello, Speedbus 47 Charlie with you, passing 1543,000.
Flap 10, please.
Flap 10.
Flap's fine.
Good morning, Wriggles, welcome. I hope you're having fun in the office. Or hope you have fun in the office.
Flaps 1. Just check for
V-pilot. Climb flight level 120.
Climb flight level 120, speedbird 47 Charlie.
Flaps up. Oh, you've got one there, thank you.
Yeah, what did he say? 2-4.
120.
1-2.
Sorry, that's 120.
Flaps up.
Flaps up.
Gear, hard to list. We've done, what percentage? Not that well, I suppose we're probably about 30% or 20-30% all the way around, something like that. Maybe not quite as much as that even. We're on day 3.
Okay, that's going to set standards. Why am I not setting standards?
It just gets stuck sometimes. You have to pull the switch out. I've pulled it out for you next time though.
Thank you. Right, command left. And the after takeoff checklist, please.
Yep.
Aren't we tired?
Yes. after takeoff checklist, landing gear.
It is up and off.
Flaps up. Air conditioning and pressurisation.
Normal.
Yep, so you just check you've got delta. There's your equivalent of your spinny clock.
Oh, yeah. Do you know what? Did you hear me when I just automatically went up
that? I saw
that.
That was quite funny, yeah. Oh, dear. And altimeters.
Standard set. 6-1 for 120.
Yep. It's quite funny because you're obviously used to flying the real thing. it's quite funny to see you keep reaching for your push to talk and then going.
See, this stuff you can't fake.
Yeah. No, the push to talk switch on there's done. Sends it to PSX. Craig even hits the transmit button.
Yeah.
But I haven't updated the software that does the ACPs to listen for that as a push to talk yet.
Oh, I see.
Passing flight level 100 to flight level 120. Standard set, cross-checked.
How do I get rid of the minimums, is that?
You have to dial them down. Which is why generally we don't bother putting them in.
Yeah, alright, it's a learning experience,
yeah,
everything.
Because yeah, yeah. The reset button on, I don't know about the 7...
Charlie, can you...
Oh yeah, we got you, 47 Charlie.
The vacuum voice rooms have literally shit themselves.
So has my captain.
right. Vertical speed. Let's let's not go too crazy. I wonder if we'll get further descent, further climb, that would be nice, wouldn't
it? Yes, that would be.
Good night, Smith. Smith Channel 610. Lovely to have you with us, and hope to see you again when you're awake at some point. Good night. It's 7:10 a.m. here in the UK, which sounds reasonably civilised, apart from the fact that we were up at 6.
Should we turn the exterior lights off?
Yes, I do apologise for my horrificness there. Actually, we're in quite feral airspace.
Leave the logo lights.
Yeah.
Is that why you're leaving the turnoffs as well? Okay.
That's all. You've been on the CRM call.
I have. Oh, look at this.
Bacon only.
Have we got red sauce? What's the sauce situation?
It should be coming, I would imagine. Any chance of higher for Speedbird 47 Charlie?
Ah, Beasley. Good morning to you, sir. Thank you very much. Make sure you're donating.
Approach Speedbird 47 Charlie.
Could you maybe poke him by text and tell him that
I think he's got some voice problems.
Yeah, just ask him for requests for further climb. Shall we go passenger signs auto?
Yeah. I'll do that for you, there you go. I'm liking the anti-faff speed there. Nice pleasing.
Well, Simon, how about a flex for my donation?
Oh, I'm wearing long sleeves now.
Yes, well, I was going to say, it is minus... Did you say it was minus two outside?
Yeah, exactly.
Hence, quite a lot of clothing being worn.
Yeah. Oh, we shouldn't have done that. It was specifically addressed to Simon to flex, not to us.
Oh, sorry.
So, obviously, there you go. We're not in demand. When Euroscope crashes, we're being handed off via the stream to centre on 123.7.
Is that the controller?
Yeah, I think so.
123.7.
Yeah.
I'll change the camera as well because it's quite dark and possibly a bit cloudy outside. Yeah. So yeah, you can't really see very much.
Ah, that's more like it.
Oh. And Prepared has crashed on the stream, which doesn't help.
Yes. So if you
you're a gentleman, thanks, Dave.
Have you killed it?
I have killed it. Right. There we go. We've got.
So there's another app that's running on there. So that's Opus FSI is running there.
That's the floweriest BAP I think I've ever seen.
It is very flowery. Hang on. I'll take that. Just sort this problem.
So the pilot's probably crashed as well, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's gone with
it.
It always does.
I will have to get rid of that.
Right. So, okay, kill that.
Okay, fine. Yeah. That's gone.
Right. So
this is what would normally happen. The first officer and the engineer deal with the technical problem while the captain sits and eats the bacon sandwich.
Right, so this thing here, we close that.
Close that.
Hopefully that'll cleanly close, which it has. That's a good one. And then, start P3D.
That. B3D.
And then you can then, as that's starting, start the FSI server.
Which is that one.
Yep. So the FSI server's feeding the weather into all the front screens.
I see, yep.
So hopefully, they all come back green. If they don't, you have to restart the client, but generally it's quite good.
Yep. I can still hear ATC. Did you say the pilot died?
Let me let you in on a secret off stream.
And I'll run. Could run the pilot actually as well now, couldn't I? No. Oh yeah.
Yeah. We have to have some secrets. A fold-out table would be nice.
Yep. Traffic, that one, yeah. Thank you.
Shall we climb anyway as we're off?
Yeah, I was thinking that.
I'm alright for the moment, I've got a coffee, but Gary...
Oh, yeah. God. Oh. That was near miss. Hello.
Teas and coffees?
I've got tea, thank you.
I'm okay for tea, thank you.
Thank you.
Right, 370 then. Enough.
Okay.
Ding, ding.
It says, it's still booting.
Yeah.
P3D, isn't it?
It might crash for the first, P3D might crash on the first startup, but we might as well just hope for the best.
What could go wrong?
Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Well, I'm using my jeans to wipe off the flour at the moment.
Apologies if we go a bit quiet for a few moments. Just having a little moment with a bacon sandwich.
Wales, I don't fly the Airbus. It would be a nice thing to have. Oh, of course, I hadn't mentioned that I fly a plane. No. What we do on... Ah, a donation. Perfect timing. What we do on older school aircraft is use the tech log, put it on one's lap, and that becomes the table. Weasels, £10. James ought to donate his bacon sandwich. Do you know what, Beasley? On Sunday morning, I will buy you a bacon sandwich. How's that? And if you donate another tenner, I'll make it a sausage and bacon sandwich. Who is taking Agnes shopping today? Yes, very kind.
Okay, so Prepare did crash on the first start. Try again. Yeah.
You said P3D crashed, even though it's moving.
This is the joy. Three in here.
Yeah.
These run the visuals, they do their own thing.
Yeah.
There's a P3D instance on the Twitch PC.
Yeah.
Which takes the traffic injection from VPilot and talks to VPilot.
Oh, okay.
And then takes the weather and sends it to these three.
So the cam that they watch on, that you watch on the stream, is not the same technically as this. It's not the same PC.
It's the instance on the Twitch PC.
Ah.
So from the sim will stay running. We keep the same weather we've got. Everything stays in sync and stays running. But then he just in the background has to have a little faff.
Oh.
Because there's
a little background.
The problem is wide server.
Yeah.
So we use the wide traffic component of wide view, and that component crashes on the server all the time. Well, not all the. I mean, we've had 2 days without it crash, but yeah.
That's good. Saying that, we don't seem to. It's either really quiet or we don't have any traffic at the moment.
Oh yeah, and the best thing is you stay in their voice room, so you can go, "I'm very sorry, we just had the issue. We're back with you."
Yeah.
The aim at some point is to write a VATSIM client for PSX.
Yeah. Well, I'd...
So I started off on the can I sign the NDA to get access to it, and it just turned into an enormous faff and I lost the will to live.
I'm not surprised, but generally most VATSIM things result in that.
But it can't be that difficult because we've already done a lot of the stuff, so it's just a matter of get the VATSIM protocol bit and shove that
It's the paperwork side of things. Yeah. Adam made a check.
That's passing 205... now for flight level 370 standard set cross checked.
What would be nice that I thought about on mine in the very distant future, I mean we're talking lofty goals, is to have some sort of VPilot integration through the FMC. So on FMC COM or ATC you've got, you know, ATSU, data link, and then you've got VATSIM and you can do it off there.
Yeah, what we do is scrape the text chat, so they send you a text message.
Comes through like an
if
ACARS
we
message.
Convert it to either an ACARS message or a CPDLC call or something.
Yeah.
Cell call works quite well.
Does it? What? Have you? I take it you've got the real cell call tone. Yeah. Oh, really? Oh, yes, indeed. Yeah, I got the radio to work so far, and I've got the FCU to work, but I don't know if I'm going to go to Cardiff today, because I haven't heard from the guy yet. I might just sleep. Benny, the way Benny's rostered it is I have a morning flight and an evening flight, so I don't have quite enough time to get back to Dartford to see my parents. And actually get some quality sleep, so either I'm going to try and do some ad hoc swapping, or which might make Benny cry, or I'll just grin and bear it, ensconce on the sofa. Yeah, oh, okay. Gary, can we get a free roam camera view this year? Did that come to fruition?
We do have it.
A Wonder Cam?
Yes, we have a Wonder Cam.
Where is it? I haven't seen it.
We plug it into that USB port there. Benny's nicked the camera for his streaming, but we're going to
get it back. Oh, I see. Yeah, we'll see about getting that back, the Wonder Cam. Which livery do we use?
And we're back.
Well, it's a British Airways modelled operation, so it's a British Airways livery aircraft. Someone upstairs
yeah,
says no free roam. It
yeah,
crashes
it crashes XSplit, unfortunately.
Oh. What's
it has done, it's, yeah.
That because we unplugged it? Unplugged it in? It's the thing
oh,
that
well, because it's coming on and off and on and off, oh. Rather than it being constantly plugged in.
Take that back. We don't have a roaming cam this year.
Are we sure he's streaming?
No.
Who knows what Benny's doing with the camera? He said he needed to borrow it, and I think the less asked, the better. Oh, we're back on. Shall we check in?
Yeah, that's Simon. He just gets on with it. It works.
Yeah. A man of action rather than a man of words. That's what we like.
Control speedway to 47 Charlie. Radio check. I think the Australians...
Is it 120.7?
1237?
1207, try that.
Control speedway to 47 Charlie, radio check.
Speedway 47 Charlie.
Hey. Speedway 47 Charlie is with you. We just had a disconnection. We're just passing flight level 280 for 370, just past Kelso.
We got you.
Hey, you're confirm you're passing flight
level. Near enough. Yeah.
Yep, passing that now. 47 Charlie.
Morning, Liz. Blocked.
Continue climb flight level 370. Oh, good evening, Clipper.
Morning, Borax.
That was lovely, but I am now covered in flour.
Yeah.
I've got some suspicious looking white stains on my trousers.
Have we got it in our beards as well? That would look even more awesome. What happened there? I saw the lights. Cargo detect air. We look like we've got zero duct pressure.
Yes.
Okay.
But the packs are still running.
Very strange. Okay, QRH checklist cargo detector air.
That's got a carrot on it, so it won't have one, will it? Oh no, does it? That mean it has one?
Yeah, a carrot doesn't have any associated actions.
Oh, so it's for our awareness?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Right.
But how can we have...
no duct pressure?
The cabin rate's okay.
It's pressurising.
Unless it's...
oh, cargo debt air.
Oh, that's another bleed duct leak,
that's
right.
That's what we were waiting for.
Okay, right. QRH checklist, bleed duct leak, right, I have the radio.
Yeah. That's the thing with the jumbo, it takes a while for the actual thing to appear.
We've got zero duct pressure, so this
bleed
will be interesting.
Bleed duct leak, right. Bleed duct leak, right, 2.2.
Is this going to be one that we can... because of the isolation valve?
He's going to follow us.
Okay.
Right, bleed duct leak, right. A bleed duct air leak occurs on the right duct.
Okay.
And our objective is to isolate the bleed duct leak.
Okay.
Right, bleed duct leak, right is shown.
Yeah.
Go to step 11.
Okay, if I get my QRH out as well, that might be useful. Oof,
I can bring that here. Here we go.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's better.
Can you see that?
Yeah.
Step 11, the isolation valve switch affected side,
unaffected side,
yep. Well spotted,
yep.
Just testing, is on. So left hand side on.
Correct.
Yeah. Isolation valve affected side off.
Which so is that side, so confirm, that needs to go off.
Right.
Yep.
Yep. Off. Off.
Okay. And that's it closed there.
Yep.
Whoa.
Whoa, whoa, whoa,
we don't
whoa,
like
whoa,
that.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Let's
it's settled. Yeah. Oh.
We've got duct pressure on the left again. That's probably why it's the change.
Yeah.
Let's go to VS just to... while we look at this.
Yeah. Okay, we still have some more work here to do.
Yep.
Engine bleed air switches affected side off. This isolates the air source and maintains pressure on the unaffected side.
The engine bleeds off, yeah,
yes.
Okay.
Engine bleed air switches affected side, which is 3 and 4.
Yep.
Confirm?
Yep, confirmed. That was 1,000 to go.
Okay. Pack control selector on the affected side off. So that's right.
Yep.
Off.
Okay.
So we've completely isolated the right hand side.
Okay, yeah.
Hydraulic demand pump 1 or 4 on the affected side off.
So that'd be number 4 then, won't it?
Number 4,
yep.
Demand pump. Confirm?
Yep.
Off. And number 16, the wing anti-ice switch. Off.
Yep. Okay.
Confirm?
Confirmed. Do not use wing anti-ice.
Do not use wing anti-ice. Note, for nacelle anti-ice operation, at or above 10,000, maintain the affected engine at 60%.
Yeah.
Below 55%.
Okay.
And plan for a lower than normal descent rate. Okay.
Okay.
Do not accomplish bleed off,
which yep.
we've got, and hydraulic press DEM 1 or 4.
Which we have number
side.
4.
Yeah. Refer to non-normal landing distance table. And we have got a different descent checklist.
Okay.
Okay, so I'll keep that open. Oh, God.
What have we got to look ahead for?
Well, right, so we basically, the descent checklist we changed to have, you know, the one pack off, two packs on, which is fine.
One pack on, two packs off.
Oh, one pack on, two packs off. So we keep pack one on and put two
which
off.
Which is us,
yep.
Which is more important.
Obviously, fuck them. Descent checklist changes.
Yeah.
Right. Leading edge flaps move in secondary mode. During approach, allow additional time for flap extension. Do not accomplish the flaps primary.
Yeah.
When the leading edge flaps are extended or retracted, a temporary leading edge asymmetry occurs. This causes a mild rolling effect.
Okay. Well, so when we touch down, we'll put that down to the mild rolling.
Mild rolling effect.
Yeah.
Caution, do not deploy the thrust reversers to the ground, the gear touches the runway.
Okay.
And then the landing checklist is slightly amended.
After landing.
Yeah. After landing, if the bleed duct leak left message is shown, when towed to the gate with engine shut down, do that, but we're not being towed, okay? Additional information.
We like more information.
The thrust reversers are deployed, when the thrust reversers are deployed, the inboard and mid-span leading edge flaps retract, resulting in the leading edge flap asymmetry.
Okay.
If the reverse thrust reversers are deployed before the nose gear touches down, immediate and significant control input, approximately 25 to 65 degrees, may be needed. I tell you what we do.
To plan for idle for no reverse.
Literally no reverse.
Yeah.
But and once we're down, once we are definitely down and right. That's it.
Okay.
So we're probably back there to the deferred item
so
for that.
If we were to review that, we're down to half our bleed sources.
Yep.
So if we had a subsequent failure,
yep,
that would cause a pressurisation problem.
Yeah.
Potentially, if we had another duct bleed leak. Can the 7.4 maintain normal pressurisation on just one engine bleed?
Should do, shouldn't it? Just?
I think so.
Yeah.
You might, yeah.
We might have to descend to a lower altitude, but we can monitor that. And obviously, if we had another duct pressure leak, then we might be looking at having to descend to 10,000 feet.
So I'll have a quick look at the chart and just check what our sector are.
What's the MSA, this en route MSA? Yeah. I mean, we're out over the water saying that, so.
We should be okay, but we double check. Where are we? What part of the world are we?
We're in the Caribbean,
aren't we? South of Barbados.
Where's the flight plan? It should be on the flight plan.
I don't know if PFPX does it? No.
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 No, it doesn't.
I'm going to cancel those ICAS.
Please do.
We know about them all.
Are we after? Sorry,
which is normal.
The MSA.
Oh, yeah. The latest version does it.
Does it?
Yeah.
Oh, we need the latest version then.
Yeah, so to continue with the review, we know what the possible failures could be after that, and in terms of our descent planning, we just need to have a longer final potentially, or just be a bit earlier with our flap extension.
Yeah. We will inform the approach controller that we need an extended downwind.
Yes.
Yeah.
That was silly.
Is it Georgetown we're going to? Soccer, found it. We don't have any problem with en route MSA.
Okay.
We're basically over the sea and a small hill.
Triptych, Benny failed our number one hydraulic system amongst many other things last night, which was why we didn't have nose wheel steering. It's remarkably unreliable, isn't it? This aeroplane.
The 25-year-old aircraft is.
And Calip.
Connecticut Hardiness. It's a different route every year. So we do world flight every year, The route is varied each year. So if you go onto our website, which is simfest.co.uk.
Well remembered.
impressive.
And go onto the World Flight page. There's a bit more information on there, and you'll be able to. In fact, the entire route is on there. There's a map showing the route and the different airfields that we're visiting on the way around. Exactly. So.
Just delete the.
I couldn't tell you.
Just delete that one.
Where we're going to Berlin, no, but I think we are going through through Germany. I wouldn't be surprised if we were.
November and then Yankee. We are not going to do that.
Are we doing Calat 1, Charlie? You've gone for.
Yeah. And I'm just tidying it so that we've got something that vaguely resembles the type of vectoring we'll get.
Vaguely sounds good to me.
Yeah. How long till top of descent? My clock's just gone off.
Oh.
So not only have we got a bloody bleed lock failure, the clock's failed.
We don't know what time it is anymore.
No. We'll add that to the tech log.
Are you not running out of pages yet?
Did you bring a tech log?
Sorry?
You never got around to printing a tech log.
No. who was I talking to?
Hello,
I was,
John. Yes, it's me.
I might have been talking to Matt, and he said...
Attacks, I think it might
he
be.
Was working. He showed me some stuff that he was mocking up, but he said it was too much faff for now.
Oh.
Smith, yeah, what happens is that when you give stuff through Just Giving, it doesn't yet, is not yet linked up to the aeroplane, so your donation very... most certainly counts, and we add it all up, but it just doesn't flash up in the aeroplane. But I think there are plans to
there are,
change
yeah.
Plans are afoot. Yeah.
Hashtag blame Craig.
Benny's obviously changed the crew, so now I'm not just Hawkey. I'm James. I fly aeroplane. Did I mention I fly planes, Hawkey?
Let's have a look. I'm just giving. What have we got here then? Let's.
Ah! An alarm! Not a technical problem,
okay,
thankfully.
I will immediately not panic.
From Smith CH 610, £40, 35.925 pence. I guess that must have been done in dollars then.
Hashtag blame Craig.
Yeah. Thanks for doing this for charity and keeping me entertained. From Chris in Seattle, USA.
You're most
welcome, Chris. Thank you very much for your donation.
Yes, thank you, Chris.
Is it raining in Seattle today? Thank you very much, mate. Cheers, Smith CH.
Should we leave that somewhere? Oh, no. See, maybe when we cover the donation printer, that's when the donations come through.
Right.
My arms are going to get tired. Your turn.
Right, what we got? We have £16.1437.
Okay.
Go that way really fast if nothing gets in the way, turn. That's from Leangi MP. Are you an MP?
I don't know.
I don't know. Thank you very much for your donation. Very much appreciated.
No, that could be LA Genie. Or it could be...
LA Genie MP. Thank you very much. Thank you, much appreciated.
Angus's bag has arrived.
Yay!
Bring on the gimp masks.
Oh, there's another donation from Chris Smith. Or, it's hard to tell. It's probably, I don't know if it's the same or if he donated twice. Either way, thank you very much. Much appreciated.
So on the stream, everybody, we're on our way to wherever it is, to Santo Domingo, I think. No.
Well, you should swap him. Hello.
Yeah. Sure, we'll Hello. Put you in the chat instead. Yeah, exactly.
Oh, dear.
I was kicked off altogether here. Is it usually not some stuff?
So the crew have got a bleed duct leaked, a right bleed duct leak failure at the moment, which you can't see too much at the moment, hence pack three off.
Allow me to.
There you go. And at the moment, everything is under control and nice and calm.
In the words of Clive Dunn, don't panic.
Yes, yeah. But according to the QRH, unless I deploy the thrust reverser as well, the nose wheel's not on the runway.
Yeah.
We may have, I think what it says, rather severe rolling motion.
Yeah, up to a 65 degree input required on the controller. So, the thing about...
Do you want me to leave that open with the... we'll get that out in a bit. We just have to remember that.
We've got about 250 miles for top of descent. The thing we need to consider is once we've dealt with the failure, we need to think about what the ramifications of that failure are. So because we've in effect lost half our bleed air system, if we were to lose the other half, have something like a duct leak on the left-hand side, maybe a pack problem or something like that, that would have ramifications as well. And on top of that, when we plan our approach into French Guiana, we're going to have to take a longer approach because we need to extend the flaps using an alternate system. So once we've dealt with the failure, it's not a case of putting it aside and getting our drinks back out. We have to think about how we're going to plan our approach and what the knock-on effects are going to be.
Don't mind Gary, he's just having a small fat.
A moment. Oh yeah, it's the election today, isn't it? The US election. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, we weren't in VNAV after all that time. Now we're in VNAV. I'm surprised someone in the stream hasn't pointed that out. What airframe do I fly? I fly the 737. I don't know.
Mention it
I
much.
Haven't mentioned that, no.
Oh, have you broken it? What mode?
Just some minor technical difficulties. Stand by for normal service to resume. Yes, thank you, whoever's upstairs. Gary has killed the camera, yes he has. The next waypoint is Trap and then Milux, yes.
Is it that button on the bottom there?
Marcus, the company Jet2 are recruiting, so there's always jobs available. Have we fixed it? Sort of. Not like frozen in place with your face in front of it or anything like that.
Yeah, Holger, so you know how you fly aeroplanes for a living.
Well, I'm surprised that people knew that. Yeah. I hadn't mentioned it.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, I don't know how Wales has
found that
out.
Well, the secret's out, yes. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Is it true you're told to brake hard on landings? It's cheaper on brakes than fuel.
No, that's not particularly true. One common misconception about braking and reverses is on a dry runway, you will stop in the same distance whether or not you will use reverses or not, assuming you use auto brakes. Because when you select a setting on the auto brake and on the 7.3 you've got 1, 2, 3 or max, it will command a rate of deceleration rather than a stopping distance. So I don't know what the specific rates of deceleration are. Obviously, max is the most and one is the least. What you do when you then pull the reverses when you stop on a dry runway only, we're talking about here, is you reduce the workload on the brakes by using the reverses to modulate the rate of deceleration between the reverses and the brakes. So you save brake wear by using reverses. Now, that's not true on a wet runway. On a wet runway, thrust reverses actually add to your stopping distance. Oh, a donation. I'll get to that in just a sec. Actually add to your stopping distance. So on a wet runway, if it's performance limiting, of course you would use the reverses, and the same thing goes when you've got contaminants as well, like snow, ice or what have you. But there are very clever people in the office upstairs somewhere, I don't know, at most airlines, that decide what is cheaper, use of fuel or use of brakes. One, 126 decibel 9, Spibber 47 Charlie, good morning.
Can we fit the simulation, can the simulator fit into the living room? No, it is. Well, I suppose it depends how big your living room is.
Look at this.
Yeah.
Angus has just donated another £400. My bag finally arrived a little late, but better late than never. Well, I'm glad you've got your costumes now, Angus.
Yeah.
We're looking forward to seeing them this week.
And thank you very much.
Thank you very much for that very, very kind donation. We're really racking them up now. We must be getting towards 12,000.
Yeah.
Centre, good morning. Speedboat 47, Charlie, flight level 370, direct to Milex.
Speedboat 47, Charlie. Roger, Centre, identified. Continue, flight boundary.
Flight boundary, Speedboat 47, Charlie. Do airports limit use of reverses? That, for safety reasons, no, but there is an argument that if you were to land at 2 o'clock in the morning, for example, one of my colleagues lives literally right at the end of the runway at Leeds and he has two new kids. Now, you've got to try and take your environment into consideration. People don't really appreciate an airplane coming in full reverser at 2-3 o'clock in the morning. So if you could be a good neighbour to the local residents and just use the brakes, then that is better. Some airlines policy, they might want you to use reverses rather than brakes because fuel is cheaper than using brakes, but that's one of the things that you have to decide as an operating pilot, which I don't think I mentioned.
No, certainly not.
Oh, it was a previous donation, just catching up. Oh, okay, well, still £400 is £400, isn't it?
Yeah. Morning, Jemmy 1339, and Jemmy 1339's 5-month-old daughter.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Gary would wave, but he's left the flight deck. I guess.
He's left the flight deck in
he's leaving
quite
the,
a state.
He's letting
actually.
The cold air in as well, which is even more concerning. What have you missed? Rambarab. Rob, at the moment, we've
when
left
were you
it,
last here?
Well, he was here last night, so we've left it up on the screen more for the stream. We would have, of course, cancelled it off. No. But we've had a bleed duct leak. So at the moment, we've isolated the right-hand duct system, and we've turned off both the bleeds from engine 3 and 4. So at the moment, everything is okay. However, when we get towards French Guiana, we're going to have to run a little bit longer for our final so that we can get the leading edges out correctly. And there's some knock-on effects which will, when Gary comes back, we can go through and we can brief. John Barnes, is he a friend of yours?
Yeah, well, he was. No, John, I think you'll find that is my double crown.
Oh, I see. I would worry. I mean, Prince William's done all right for himself, hasn't he? So, Wales, that's not as silly as it sounds. Airlines hedge their fuel, so it's quite a complicated, expensive business. So they'll look at fuel prices, a bit like when, if at the moment, if you were to buy US dollars, do you do it now or do you wait until after the US election because the dollar rate will change? Well, fuel prices are fluctuating all the time, so someone in the office has to make that decision. We're going to buy fuel now and we'll buy at this price and we're going to buy this much fuel at that price. And so what you can do, you can hedge. And the way the reason airlines do that is because fuel then becomes a fixed operating cost. They can say fuel is going to cost us, I don't know what the price of fuel is. Is it $800 a tonne?
Don't know.
J1?
Couldn't tell you.
I don't know. I think it's about that. So they're going to pay $800 a tonne, for example, for the next 6 months or for the next 100,000 tonnes or something like that. And that keeps the bean counters happy because that way it's one less of a flexible cost to absorb and it just makes it easier to price fares. Then you've got fixed price for en route, fixed price for fuel, fixed price for crews generally. The only flexible cost after that is things like passenger compensation. If you have delays, technical problems, and yeah, the technical problems themselves, engineering costs, things like that.
Morning, Wills B3 and Virtual 170. Elderly racer, wouldn't the passengers notice this failure? And yeah, as Dave has said.
Yeah.
No.
No, it's all quite transparent. It hasn't affected the cabin pressurisation system at the moment. So there wouldn't be a notice. If we lost more bleeds, they probably would notice because the masks would come down and we'd have to go down very quickly.
I notice, James, that you've got the speed window open.
Yeah, that's not intentional.
Yeah.
For some reason, I can't cancel the speed window. Let's try going into out hold.
So if you go into VNAV.
Go to VNAV.
Put in.
Ah.
Point, yeah, put in 0.8. Oh, yeah,
it's
there.
It's done now. It's just, yeah. I think it's just a little bit laggy with the windows.
Yeah.
Gary would have noticed that if he was here, of course.
Yeah.
Ah.
Doing his monitoring job.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh! I went this morning. I thought it was going to be late, and of course, I hadn't even
I'm alive.
We had a frequency change. We're with a new centre. I can't pronounce who they are, so they're just centre.
Right.
There has been no subsequent technical failure.
Right, that is good to know.
So far. I'm just listening to them. They're basically giving them to Caleb and then giving them vectors. So we'll brief in a little bit.
Alright. Baba. Very bright out there.
Yeah.
Very cold.
Is it, of course, the sun's,
the sun's come up now.
I went to look actually because it was forecast to snow in Leeds. Either, I think it was last night or the night before. Sorry, last night or tomorrow night. Aero weather. Oh, I'm looking through my phone. I could get the weather for Leeds Bradford on here, couldn't I?
Yeah.
0 degrees in Leeds. Oh, tempo.
Yes. I
was going to say tempo tonight from 10 till 6, 2,000 metres in rain and snow. Prop 30 tempo between 11 and 6 at all night. 800 metres in snow broken at zero.
That's displeasing.
That, Well, it is, because my other half is obsessed with Christmas.
Oh.
And so I'm kind of a bit in the doghouse because I can't go out and frolic in the... Well, not frolic, but make snowmen.
Frolic naked in the
frolic snow. Frolic naked in the snow and make snow angels and things like that.
Hold hands and skip.
Yeah.
Oh, Simfest already answered John Barnes.
Yeah.
Yes. Very, Hello. Definitely. This headset, me hearing myself, is a lot quieter than it is in all the others.
Again, I think that's probably the gating, isn't it? Is there a squelch on this? Or is it all through?
It's not a squelch. Even if I talk loud, I can't... Shall I have a look? Shall we have a... Can we have a play? Let's have a play. What have we got here? Right. F-O mix. Hello, testing.
It's not snowing yet.
Testing.
Ah, my other half is watching. Vicky is... Hello.
Hello, Vicky.
Hello. Yeah, it's going to snow tonight.
Hello. Hello. No, weird. Can you talk a second, James? Say hello.
So that's output, isn't it?
The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog.
What do you want is input.
What, so you think that my input is
Yeah, because look, so you're changing...
my output.
So if you change that, that's your output, that's what you're hearing.
Yes.
So you need...
But my level is the same level as him.
You sound alright to me.
Yeah, so I sound okay to everyone else, it's just me hearing myself.
Speak again.
Testing.
Hello, well, I'm 1-2, you see, so I'm up there somewhere.
One, two,
three.
I think you are a bit quieter.
Yeah?
I think so.
But am I quieter on the stream, is the question. So, that's the bell ringer we need to go and tweak.
Yeah.
We think my input's low.
Yeah. Well, it is, I think.
Yeah.
Because I think there's a gate on it, which I think is not, which could probably come down a little bit, because.
But I don't think I'm gating.
You are, because there's not. You should be able to hear something, and it must be input because I can't hear you properly either.
Oh, can't you?
No, you're.
I'm not cutting in and out because I am definitely talking.
Yeah.
You can hear me, but it's just, yeah. So we just need to bump the input up a bit then.
I think so.
Tweak the bell ringer. I should tweak the bell ringer.
Marcus, I didn't see your previous question. So you're rated, but you have no time on type. Well, that's a bit of a tricky one because a lot of airlines for ab initio cadets want you to have time with them. So, might be having to look a bit further afield. I mean, I don't know where you're based, but some Eastern airlines will take people without experience. It's always just worth sending CVs out constantly and nagging people, because some airlines HR departments are better than others, and sometimes you can get lost in the ether. So just because you haven't had a reply, you know, give it a month, 6 weeks, and then there's nothing wrong with a quick phone call to say, oh, did you get my application? And they start to remember who you are then. And it goes either two ways. They either think, oh, well, he's a persistent chap, we might give him an interview, or they'll just put you on the block list. It's like a game. If you're thinking about getting a job as a pilot, don't pick a type rating that you think you want to fly an aeroplane, because if that were the case, everyone would pick like a type rating on Concorde, and of course you'd be unemployable. You need to apply to an airline that will take cadet pilots, and they will provide the type rating training. So places like Ryanair will take you without a rating. EasyJet will through CTC. Jet2 has a very good program, the pilot apprentice. Yeah, yeah. Well, we don't talk about CTC. Jet2 have got a very good pilot apprentice program, so you spend some time in the office and in the operation and actually do a bit of time as cabin crew, which is invaluable before they give you a rating, and that'll be on the 73 or 75. So the thing about if you're a cadet, you can't really afford to be picky. That's the problem. Flyby as well, yeah, that's right. They'll take people. Ah, a donation.
Ah. ERUGT3RS has donated 6.211144852604 pounds.
That's probably what, $8 or something like that, or €7.
Have fun with the rest of World Flight, and I look forward to controlling you guys for the rest of World Flight and back into Australia from World Flight HQ. Thank
you. Excellent.
Who is Drew GT3RS then?
Was he? Was that the guy that was on the previous controller that we spoke to?
The one who handed off us off via stream.
Yeah, hopefully. I think so.
Oh, thanks, guys.
Excellent service as per normal. another donation.
Thank you to Greg for £20. Cheers, Greg.
It's not closed because of Brexit. It's basically closed because you get an awful lot of applications for the future pilot
because
program.
Because Brexit.
Yeah,
I like
it's
that.
Managed because Brexit. We'll just blame Brexit. It's managed by CTC, they who shall not be named, and they get about a bazillion applications. The same thing with the Virgin pilot application program, which is open now. If you want to fly 747, you can apply to Virgin, and they'll get you interviewed, and then if you're successful, you'll get a job with Virgin Atlantic. But they have to close and open periodically so that they can go through the volume of applications that they get.
The Virgin one looks interesting.
Yeah, I think it's Dreamliner, and one of my friends is on it at the moment. I had one or two of my friends who applied and who didn't get it, unfortunately.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's a bit of a minefield applying to some of these companies because they outsource the application process. And
that was very diplomatic compared to what you just said.
Yes, it was.
Yes.
Well, you just never
know. I completely agree with you.
You never know what's who's watching.
Yes, the acronym.
The acronym, yeah. CTC. Well, yes.
Oh, Wales said it's the worst place he's ever trained at.
Well, I could neither agree nor disagree.
That's funny.
When can you apply to go into Future Pilots of BA? I don't know.
No one knows, basically. Someone
goes.
In BA might know.
Yeah, if we have anyone on the stream from BA, they might be able to tell us, but it closed a couple of months back, I think. So I think it sort of opens every 6 to 12 months, so you might be looking at middle of next year, perhaps.
Yeah.
Airlines tend to do a lot of their recruitment over the winter, so they do all their type rated recruitment, and all their experienced pilots, all the direct entry type pilots, and then they get to the ab initios because they need to plan the training programs over the winter in what is traditionally the more quiet time. But I mean, places like Ryanair, Jet2, EasyJet, they're just recruiting constantly at the moment because there is a big need for pilots. Wales, all the promises of fast track, all this, just be wary, because if they're fast tracking people and they're trying to make it really appealing, it's probably because they don't have enough applicants with the current offering. Wizz Air, I know their starting salaries are very, very poor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Morning, Kev.
Morning, Kev.
Have you lost all your money yet? He's in Vegas right now.
Right, we're not far from top of descent. Should we have a bit of a talk about what's going to happen?
Yeah. Is Chris Kilroy in the chat? Because he could say hello to Kev. Yes, shall we have a chat? Yep.
Us?
Ignore the problem? No.
Good. No.
What section was it again? I've forgotten.
We could press the recall button, couldn't we? And that
2.2.
2.2, yeah, that sounds about right.
Right, so just to remind ourselves, of the... So we fly it exactly as we would normally, but yep. there is our descent checklist.
Okay, so we need the review, we need a longer final, just to allow the flap... It takes about 4 or 5 minutes to get the flaps all the way at leading edges, so... Yep. 15 miles or 10 to 15 miles, and we'll make sure we dirty up a little bit earlier. Bigger threats, speaking sort of more generally going into here, there's no terrain to speak of. Looking at it, it's on the very north and east, northeastern coast of, one of the South American countries. Well, it's French Guiana, isn't it? So, highest MSA is 2,500 to the south.
Yep.
Weather, oh. Maybe we'll put the weather radar on because there was a little
bit of... I have got it on.
You've got it on. Yeah, okay, yeah. So that's that threat mitigated.
Yeah.
And other than that, just the non-normal. If we have... We needed to plan a descent with a lower than normal rate, actually, didn't we, it said?
It said, it just said, expect...
Where was it?
Yeah, plan for a lower than normal descent rate.
So if we get descent now, we can use VS... And that'll be easier on the packs.
No, I would just be nav it as normal. It doesn't say to do anything different other than just plan for lower than the normal descent rate.
Okay.
I would just be nav, but it's up to you.
All right, I'll tell you what, I'll finish briefing and then we'll get the descent. That's maybe a little bit early,
good.
But...
Arrival
via Calip. It's either going to
It's not going to be that much different.
No.
No,
I wouldn't imagine so.
No.
Arrival via Calip.
Oh, hang on. But nacelle anti-ice, it's because we would have the thrust at 55 or 60.
If we need anti-icing, but it's cab okay at the moment.
No, we're
so,
fine.
Misread,
I do apologise.
That's fine. So, all right, we don't need to worry about that. We've looked at the weather. I've preset the QNH as 1010. At the moment, it's cab okay, but there are showers in the forecast.
Yeah.
As I was saying,
storms.
Arrival via Calip takes us in towards the CYR. Yeah. But before we get there, 40 miles, it's a right turn. And eventually we're going to get ourselves towards Kukov. Now, we should go past over the top of Kukov and then turn right and come back on ourselves because that's where the hold is, which I've got in there, but I've sort of joined it up. So we've got the shortest possible route in there. They give us anything else, I'll just ask you to put it back in. It's the ILS for runway 08, Zulu 7-10, effective date is a mystery, the 13th of March 2014.
Yep.
Jeep glide path azimuth coverage limited 6 degrees right of the final approach track. Do not take into account the glide path indication outside this limit.
Okay.
All right. So if we're well south, we can't arm the approach too early.
Yeah.
Thank you for that.
You're welcome.
110.3.
Yeah.
Which NAVRAD is in there? An inbound course of 084. 327 on the ADF. We could manually tune that, I guess. If I put down ADF left. VOR left 115.95. I'm not going to put that in just yet.
No.
Platform at 2,000 feet. That's for the procedure though. Yep. So we can expect to be vectored from 1,700 feet. Start down at 5.3.
Yep.
It's a 3-degree glide slope. Runway's nice and long, 3,200 metres, 45 metres wide. Down to minimums.
The only thing on the runway then, just for stopping.
Yeah. We were talking about reverse, weren't we?
Well, I'm just saying, auto brakes 3, is that going to get us off by that echo turn off?
I haven't actually looked at the ground plate yet, so let's... You're probably right, let's have a look.
I wonder if we auto brakes 4 to make sure we're off by echo, otherwise we're going to have to backtrack and that's a faff.
Yeah, there's that turning loop, isn't there? Saying that, we've got... that echo's about halfway down, which would be 1,600 metres. Yeah. You reckon you can stop this at 1,600 metres with no reverse?
You would with auto brakes 4.
All right, let's go auto brake.
Even. It's well flight.
Let's go max then.
Yeah.
We will come to a stop.
I could look at the landing. Do you want to look at the... I mean, we're just guessing off the chart, but it should work, shouldn't it?
I imagine so.
Landing distance. Non-normal landing distance, no reverse is what we're looking for.
It's dry, so without reverse won't make a difference. We were having this sort of discussion a bit later. Well, it doesn't do on the 7.3, so...
Non-normal landing flaps... Are we going to do flaps 30?
Yes.
Make sure we get off.
Yeah, definitely. So we can bug... Do you want to bug that now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So flaps 30.
Yeah.
Dry runway, auto brake max 1560.
1560.
That's with the flaps control, which is what we're going to have, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh no, flaps drive? No. I'm trying to work out what
FMC message, reset MCP out, call for descent if you want.
Yeah, anyway, let's just assume that's going to work.
Yeah, well, if it doesn't work, then it doesn't make a difference. We've got to land there anyway, haven't we?
Okay. So. Happy, yeah, I'm happy with the brief then, are you? Descend flight level 1 at 10.
At 100.
I thought it was 110. Just to confirm, that's flight level 110 to be levelled by Caleb. And just give us a speed again for 47 Charlie.
47 Charlie, that was flight level
100, 250 knots, levelled by Caleb. Descend at 250 and we'll be levelled by Caleb, flight level 100, speed was 47 Charlie. Does he really want that?
He's probably trying to sequence us.
Yeah.
Okay.
There we go.
Level change, 100 in the window.
Okay. Descent checklist then. Recall.
Yeah. Is checked with nothing that we don't already know about.
Auto brake.
Borset.
Landing data.
BREF for flap 30, 145, minimums 320.
Approach briefing.
It's completed. Yeah.
Right, I have control there.
You have control, so you're going to fly us in.
Yeah.
1,000 feet, if we're not happy, we'll go around.
Yeah, see where VNAV thinks we are.
Check out target. I did press the alt button, but it doesn't seem to have gone into descent mode.
No, that's probably okay. Otherwise, let me just, let's just, yeah.
It was working fine until I gave controls to Gary.
I was just trying to see where. Oh, there we go. We've got some actual profile now. There we go.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. So I'll ask you to not select reverse.
Speed up speed. There we go. We're in. Checked. We're in.
And
there
we're 4,000 feet above the profile.
That's
excellent.
Okay.
What were we to cross Caleb at? 100, which you've got in there.
Yeah. Yeah. Be all right. We should use a small amount of speed brake now just to get us going.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wheels, they do help reduce the stopping distance in the wet. Obviously, wet runways, braking coefficients change, so that's why we use reverses. But in this case, we're not going to use reverses because if we do and the nose gear hasn't touched down, the wing is going to hit the ground, for want of a better explanation. If you think about your stopping performance in your car, if it's wet and you hammer on the brakes, you're going to stop in a shorter distance if it was dry than it would if it was wet. It's exactly the same thing on an aeroplane. And if it's severely wet, obviously the grooves of the tyres, they fill with water, you start to aquaplane, it all gets very interesting. Wales, thank you, yeah.
Quite a lot. So,
it's saying we're going to make it at the moment.
Yeah, so 20 minutes to landing, will be at 8:23.
Okay.
I'll pop that in. That's our 20 minutes to landing.
Oh, I love that. We don't have that on the 7.3.
It's an additional pleasingness.
Yeah. We'd have to work it out.
Do you fly? What 7.3s do you fly?
The 300 and the 800.
Oh, yeah. So you do have the 800s as well.
Yeah. We would have to look at Caleb and think, right, 23. So 5 minutes before Caleb. So it's now 13, so that's what, 15 minutes till we get there, 23 is getting 10 minutes, so probably around, well, how many miles to go, 62, about 20 miles before Caleb, and then we'd have to do Caleb minus 20, that's what we wanted to do. Slowly coming back on the profile.
So it's depending on how busy approach is.
Thank you, Wales.
What's he doing?
Willy waving.
Oh, Willy waving.
Yeah.
Is it that big?
Well. It's the camera on the stream. I thought it made everything look very small.
Oh, okay.
So I'm trying to cope with that, you see. Oh, there's. See, that's nice. That's the 330 that we're following.
Ah,
oh, that's nice.
Where were they?
They are. There's a little. They were. Actually, they were exactly. It's 53.1 at Caleb when they sent me the picture, and that is 0.2. Descent forecast uplink ready. Would you like me to put that in for you, sir?
Yes, please. There's our descent stuff.
Okay.
So just to remind, do not deploy the thrust reversers.
I haven't said to him about an extended final yet, but I think, given the delays, we're probably going to get that anyway.
We're taught to approach, so it just...
Yeah.
I keep looking for my clock, I'm like, oh...
See, if it were to go blank, that's normally a sign of GPS write failure. But yours has just gone off altogether, hasn't
it?
Yeah, it's just like, no, sorry, I'm going to go and have a bacon sandwich.
I've overheated, I'm done.
Yeah.
Why do you expect a Windows 8 tablet to run for 7 days? Are you silly?
Is that a Windows 8 tablet that you've got behind there?
Yeah,
it's a clock.
Each clock,
Cause no expense.
Because then we can put an RMI on yours.
Is that what I thought you were going to get? Is that going to come? Well, you're probably not going to do it during World Flight, but...
We haven't really spoke much more other than yes, we'd like to do it.
Ah, I see.
Well, the profile problem is solving itself now.
Yeah. They vectored me in on like a 10-mile final. Oh, that's okay. Gary, how many flying hours have you got?
Real, about 8 or 9.
8 or 9 actual hours. How many hours do you think you've got in the sim?
Building or flying?
Well... Yeah, I guess because half the time you spend fixing things.
Exactly. Yeah.
But you've had a sim for what? 10 years? I've known you for a long time.
Yeah.
10 years. Yeah. So, I don't know. You think you do 200-300 hours a year, maybe in the sim?
Yeah. I don't really know. Yeah, I haven't really. Probably I don't log my hours or anything with anything.
One of the things I'd quite like.
Actually, you could look at VATSIM. I wonder what my VATSIM stats are.
Yeah. What's? I don't know what your CID is.
811-521.
811-521. So if anyone on the stream wants to have a look and tell us, and that'll tell you how many hours Gaz has got on VATSIM. And that's VATSIM alone, let alone being not connected and just faffing at home. Yeah, I'd quite like a tech log so I could just record where the sim's been, actually. And then you can raise the technical pages for when you add things and stuff.
Profile fixed.
That was very well managed.
Just there, where's VNAV? Come on, VNAV path is coming in. Now, there we go.
VNAV path.
Evening, Samzo.
Now I know how Craig feels.
Good morning, Russian
You think the people upstairs would be concentrating on important things like sleeping rather than inventing silly commands for the stream, wouldn't you?
Or making us a coffee. No,
yes. Well, actually, I've still got some tea. And it is actually tea. It's a little bit early for coffee.
Yes, I think I'm going to have a nap after this.
Oh, it's a bit cold now. Oof. No, I don't think I will. Don't actually. Gary has 1581 hours on VATSIM as a pilot. There you go.
Only 194 as a controller, ever.
Yeah, well that's because you start, give it 20 minutes and then rage quit, I guess.
I think I control twice a year, in fact.
Well, you were at live, weren't you?
Yeah, that could be. I think that's the only time I controlled this year.
Yeah.
Although,
but you've got a C3, haven't you?
Yeah.
How have you managed, is that from SAT UK?
Yeah.
see, I've got my S3 that's rolled over and it's taken me, I've had nearly 20 months to get a C1 and I still don't have my C1. I've had a crack at the exam, which I unfortunately failed, but...
Yeah, though, I,
Right heading 230 degrees, speed 47 Charlie.
Oh, hello. Yeah,
hello.
Hello.
160
left, heading 120 vectors for sequence.
I do like the way that he's in characteristic Caribbean. Did we, the Caribbean.
Yeah.
We must have picked him up on the way through
Barbados. Very appropriate. Tea would be lovely.
Could I have a coffee, please?
Could I? Could I have just a bottle of water, please? Is that acceptable? Maybe. Very kind. Your parrot's stuck in your hair.
Oh my god.
Who knows what you're actually going to end up getting?
I like our vectors for sequence here. They're putting us away from the airport, technically.
Yeah. Where's the rum gone? That's what I was waiting for.
Oh dear. Would there be any chance of this coming back?
Oh.
Sorry.
There we go.
Oh. There we go, thank you. Lovely.
So, that circle has disappeared, it is... Well, we don't really know how long 20 minutes is going to be now, do we?
No.
Because we're being vectored away.
I'm just going to come out of VNAV now and just...
Shall I just give them 20 minutes anyway?
Yeah.
Do you have to do a PA?
Yeah, there we go. Our work is done, yeah. Although we have found that if you do it, don't push the RT, because Benny's programmed that when you do PA for 2 seconds, if the doors are armed, it will start then putting them into manual.
Oh.
But it doesn't check you on the ground before that
okay.
happens.
Hashtag blame Benny.
Yeah.
Yeah, if people could put that in the stream, that would be really great, actually.
I'm enjoying my sequencing.
17,000 hours with Noble Air. How long have you been flying for Noble Air?
Yeah. Diamond Kelsey's diplomatic relations are on the case.
Yeah.
There may be a small issue with that, and I think I've realised why we're going in this direction, because actually whoever we were speaking to is no longer there.
Oh.
Who were we speaking
1269.
To? 1269. Oh no, 1283 it says it.
Radar, Speedbird 47, Charlie Radio Jack.
Speedbird 47, Charlie. I'm fine.
Thank you, sir. Do you know how long until we can expect a left turn back towards Calab?
Very diplomatic.
Diplomacy is one of my strong suits.
Yes. That's a hint, isn't it?
Yeah, as in, we're going the wrong fucking way. Ah, he's adopted the Spanish approach for ATC, which is ignore the problem or just give it to the next controller.
Hopefully he's on chat. He's on chat.
It's quite funny, because if we ask Barcelona or something like that... Left turn heading south, Speedbird 47 Charlie.
Hint taken.
You are our new favourite controller. Thank you, 47 Charlie.
Yeah, 47 Charlie, you'll be just next in sequence, so you can go to Caleb, and then after Caleb, fly heading 170, vectors for the approach.
Go back to Caleb and then 170. Okay, back to Caleb and then leave Caleb heading 170 degrees. Speed 47 Charlie.
Did he touch my autopilot?
No.
Did I do that? I did 180?
You did the heading. I was looking at this. I don't remember going to 100. I thought we were to... Oh, no, it was 100. It wasn't 130.
Am I broken?
No, you're... Well, no, I definitely saw you put the heading in. Craig has been blamed 99 times. I've got to work that out. So if Noble's been flying since 2010, that's 6 years, and in 6 years he's done 17,000 hours. How many hours are there in a year? 24 times 365.25. There's 8,000 hours. He's going to maintain flight level 90, relieve Caleb Helling 170, speed before 7 Charlie.
That, what was that, 9?
Down to 9 and leave Caleb 170.
142. Cheerio, virtual 170, bye bye.
I'm going to test something in a second. Oh yeah, no, sorry, I was just...
Good morning, Magsy 63.
So if there's 8, just under 9,000 in a year, 6 years, 9, 18, 20, 36, 45, 54. He's been on flight sim for a third of his life over the last 6 years, if my maths is correct.
How many?
126 decimal 6, speed by 47, Charlie, good morning. What was the ATIS we had? A bit old, but November. Who are they? Let's address them by their proper title.
They are.
KN.
Yeah.
KN approach, bonjour, speed at 47, Charlie descending flight level 90, direct Caleb to leave Caleb heading 170, 747-400 with November.
10 checks, please.
Okay, the... All of them?
Yeah, why not?
Dr. Have a French.
3000 on the
KNQNH 1018, direct Kukoff for the ILS 0110. Okay, direct to Kukoff for the ILS 08, descend altitude 3000 feet, QNH 1010, speed before 7 Charlie.
And the very early descent.
Oh, yeah, but.
Oh.
VNAV, idle VNAV speed.
Johnson 1 Victor Bravo, thank you, over the tower 118.
Shall we put 3000 in the window? Or?
I'm going to now.
Ah, excellent.
That was subtle.
Sorry, I'm still working on my subtlety.
Oh.
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 VNAV path.
No. Or O. Have a look on the ICAS.
Oh,
you bell ends.
Aileron lockout. Okay, one thing at a time. Set Q&H.
Yeah. 10,
10.
9,000,
descending for 3,000.
Yeah.
Maintain heading now,
140. Fly heading 140 degrees, speed before 7 Charlie.
Okay, shall I continue flying and take the radio?
You continue flying at the radio and I'll get my QRH out and have a look at this.
Gary.
Someone's calling.
Robert. I'm assuming.
Aileron lockout, chapter 9.1.
Your bowels intrigue me.
What did he say?
I don't know. Aileron lockout.
Did you just say that my bowels intrigue you?
Aileron lockout. An aileron lockout actuator is not in the commanded position.
Too much information.
The aileron, sorry, say that again.
An aileron lockout actuator is not in the commanded position.
Okay.
Why don't you take my course? At high airspeed, avoid large or abrupt control wheel inputs.
Right, that's going to be difficult.
Yeah. Crosswind limit for landing is 20 knots, which is not going to be a problem for us today. Cat 2 and Cat 3 autoland is not approved. End of checklist. Aileron lockout checklist complete.
So no abrupt movement.
No abrupt movement. So we have to, almost like we're in treacle.
Slow this.
Right. And you cleared that. That's excellent. End of checklist. I have the radio.
Pass it.
Just like that.
Lovely. Seamless. Yeah. In the galley. Blue trolley. Fourth drawdown.
Oh, I didn't know that. That's quite nice. That's a pressy of the situation that we've had.
What?
Aileron lockout. Yes. No speed, thank you. Speed before 7 Charlie. Ah,
what's
that? Anti-fat.
Cabin ready. Yeah, should we just.
Well,
not too much because.
Yes. Yeah.
We don't want large or abrupt control movements.
Yeah, so yeah. Let's not anti. We should probably start trying to get some flaps out.
Drag required. Okay.
Can we go flaps one? Because this could take some time.
We can, right, flaps one. It's the flaps one that. It's flaps five that takes a long time, isn't
one
it?
One to five.
One to five,
take
okay.
Forever, because it's the leading edge just.
Yeah.
Thank you, Dave.
Water behind you.
Oh, you're very kind, thank you.
Busser.
An excellent year. Does James fly in real life, Magsy? Do you know what? It's funny, that question hasn't come up yet. I am a pilot. It's not been mentioned, has it?
That's him willy waving, by the way, if you just joined.
If you exclamation mark willy waving, and you, yeah, Benny obviously has far too much time on his hand. Flaps primary.
We
told us to
that.
Ignore that, yeah. So that will be cancelled. 1 when they will realise how long it would take for alt flaps. Elderly
okay.
Racer, we...
Flaps 5 as well now.
Flap 5, what are we, speed? Yeah, okay.
This would be the mild rolling moment.
Oh, I wonder what was happening.
Yeah, although we're not actually...
I like the way we're having...
If you gave it a bit of rudder, that might correct the mild rolling moment.
Just leave it.
Oh, oh, your rudder pedals don't work, do
no,
they?
No, can you just centre those rudders, actually? Oh.
Let's go that side, that's probably better, bearing in mind with the way the roll is.
It's probably the yaw damper trying to do something there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Look how much it's got the ailerons over.
Is that the aileron lockout? But no, that can't
no,
be.
No, it's the mild rolling moment. Right, because the front leading edge on the right hasn't come out yet.
Yeah. If I were to...
Because the left leading edge is...
rudder to centralise the ball, so to speak. No, because it's still coming back out now. That'll do. I can't...
That's it, that's the damper problem.
Yeah, there you go.
Right, I'll keep this up.
And actually, we've nearly got all the leading edges out now.
Probably doesn't want us doing a bit of an issue.
It would be a lot more fun flying an Airbus. Well, we wouldn't really be flying if it was an Airbus. We'd just be button pressing.
Oh, thanks, Steve. Hello.
Hello.
I think the bot is dead. No, it's not. It still does the willy waving thing.
It's because we've just had to go willy waving so many times in a short period of time.
We need a break between willy waves, yeah. so some downtime.
Yeah.
Well, we've learned that the autopilot doesn't disconnect in the flaps primary thing because of the aileron lockout.
Oh, yeah, we have. Yeah, because we've got an aileron lock. So why on earth, when you lose the flap control units, does the autopilot disengage and become unengageable?
So did you have this before when you had the flap problem then, that you couldn't get the autopilot in?
No, we had a full flap control failure.
Echo 47, Charlie, if you could give me your best speed, 250 for Racing.
Just not more than 250 because of the flaps. It'd be speed 250 max just at this stage. We have a small flap problem we're dealing with. Speed 47, Charlie. We'll do our best to expedite. Yeah, now we've got...
Speedboat 47, Charlie, disregard. Get you to track now heading 180, you'll be number 3.
Oh, no, we don't want that, do we?
Oh, we can do it. No, we're
okay, track 185, Speedboat 47, Charlie, thank you. He didn't specify.
What's the 250 over to the tower?
180, I thought.
Was it? 180, 185.
Here we go that.
Yeah, that's about right,
yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Split the difference.
He was trying to anti-faff us, but in this situation, it was appreciated, but...
Yeah, of course. Interesting, the aileron lockout thing has disappeared.
Because we're going lower?
I don't know. But it's not on recall. It would be on recall, would it not?
It's unjammed itself.
Yeah.
Yeah, it would be on recall.
And it would be down there.
Yeah.
So,
amazing.
How fascinating. We are heading 180 now already, Speedbird 47 Charlie.
He crashed.
Oh, hang on.
Altimeters.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, further right, 20 degrees.
Okay, heading 200, Speedbird 47 Charlie. Are you happy with 250 knots, or do you want us to reduce?
Oh yes, it has.
Oh.
Speedbird 47, drop off then.
Yeah,
I'll tell him.
We're just going to drop off line, yeah.
The radar, Speedbird 47 Charlie, we've just got a problem with our connection. We might drop offline very briefly. We'll be back shortly.
Okay, so that has to go. FSI server has to go.
Shall we bring the speed back? Because otherwise, yeah, we're just going to end up flying the wrong
way.
Oh,
does. Is there something else running on
no,
here?
No, just get P3D coming back, and then get Opus coming back.
P3D, FSI server.
We are working on the technical difficulties on the stream at the moment.
I just want to come back to flaps for 5 speed.
Yeah. Are you going to get a new light plate? Should I ask Phil if one can be appropriated? Alt capture. Malachi, it's not a problem with the VATSIM server for once. It's just one of the computers has crashed the P3D instance.
That connects us to VATSIM.
Yeah.
The SIM is still flying perfectly.
Yeah, this is the good thing about having PSX external to P3D and using P3D just for visuals, because we can carry on flying, the stream can carry on functioning, and we're not having to cope with this constant pause and having to reload, etc, etc. It works very well.
Traffic proxy, do we have to do?
No, that's fine.
Yeah, I have, yeah.
Thanks, Kev.
I'm assuming that Rob would probably want us to be doing something like this.
Yeah. Well, he was trying to build space, wasn't
we
he? So.
Space.
What do we got to do checklist wise? Should we do deferred items approach checklist?
Yes.
Altimeters.
Check.
To QNH1010.
That's it.
Caution, do not deploy the thrust reversers until the nose gear contacts the runway. That hasn't been mentioned in the checklist up to this point, has it?
No.
They're just landing checks to do and then the afterlanding.
Loading,
stuff,
hopefully.
Strictly speaking, there was that PAX thing.
That top of descent, that PAX control selectors. One PAX on, two PAX off.
Oh.
Do we pretend you already did that?
Yeah.
It doesn't seem to have caused a problem, actually.
Sorry, we missed that. Well done, Simon.
It's nice having a flight chair.
Yeah.
Human auto-throttle.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's what we should do. The flight engineer should do the...
Barrow disagree.
That's me.
Oh, well.
Bremer.
Got away.
Still loading.
Magsy, running total of donations to date. We'll work on an exact figure, but I think we're past 12,000 now.
Yeah, I think.
Which is excellent. Long may it continue. The new target is 15,000. So if you want to contribute, Please do. The more contributions we get, the more the sim gets a bit more exciting, doesn't it?
Second reading.
Yes.
At what point do you get the ILS needles?
Oh, you about 25 miles,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah,
so
I would have been...
Just a PSA.
Ah,
there we go.
Thing. Yeah, there we go. Localizer capture. I did brief the missed approach, actually. Straight ahead to 1700, max 230 knots, right turn to CYR, going to 2000.
Probably okay. Yeah, we're back now, we've given him a call.
Yep.
Yeah.
Radar, hello, Speedbird 47, Charlie, we're back with you, 3000 feet at 20 DME. No problem, we maintain high speed and clear ILS approach runway 08, Speedbird 47 Charlie. We've obviously spawned on top of someone.
Plus 142, unfortunately, an aircraft just appeared back on the scope.
Left turn
now heading 190.
Sorry.
Sorry, Jed.
Yeah.
They respond.
Sorry, gents.
Cross 142, disregard. Do one left hand orbit present position, please. Short delay.
Hi, Mrs. Horgy. Bye, Steve.
See you later, Vic. I will text you, of course.
We're doing it. So, once we're inside Kokov,
It's just, okay, good.
We've given him that high speed though, we're on.
Glide slope alive.
Okay.
Oh, donation! Oh, excellent. It all happens in the heavy workload points. Let's have a look. The message says, from Kirsty, £5, well done, Birdmen. We're the people of the sky. That's very kind of you.
Thank you, Kirsty.
Kirsty, thank you very much. All donations appreciated, no matter how large or how small.
Flap 10, please.
Flap 10 is coming. Who calls 1,000? Do I call 1,000 feet?
Yeah.
It automatically calls.
It does. Okay. So at 1,000, you go stable.
Stable 320 barrow visual, I have control, something
yeah,
like that.
Something like that.
Oh.
What?
Is that a.
That looks like an airport.
Is that an airport or, yeah?
Should we go mood lighting?
Yeah, I like mood lighting. Glide slope capture.
Okay. I'm just going to keep that speed up for a bit for him. Okay, flaps 20.
Up 20.
20 miles final. Aircraft is unresponsive.
Bit 47, Charlie, fully established,
radio
8 miles.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, over to tower 118.1,
118.1, Speedbird 47 Charlie, thanks for your help, good night.
On this 120.
Tower low, Speedbird 47 Charlie, heavy, 7.5 miles, fully established, 08.
Speedbird 47 Charlie,
Cayenne
power, today.
Runway
08,
Finland. Yeah, why not? Finland 08, Speedbird 47 Charlie.
Gear down, please.
Gear down, certainly, sir.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, roll through to Echo.
Roll to Echo, speedboat 47 Charlie.
Cayenne Tower, Beechcraft 6875 Romeo, ready to go runway 8, Charlie intersection.
30, please.
But straight to 30 from 325,
yes,
okay.
Server 6875 Romeo, Cayenne Tower, good day. Call short runway 08. Holy short runway 08.
Landing checklist?
Yes, please.
Speed break?
Is. Armed.
Landing gear.
Ears down.
Flaps.
30.
Cabin report.
Received.
Yes. That's the landing checklist complete.
Okay, good.
After landing, if the bleed duck left message, that doesn't apply, so you yep. put that down somewhere.
Okay. I think, yeah, that's probably going to be alright. You might find the ILS is slightly misaligned with the runway to the left, but you're probably okay.
Okay.
Probably not that far off.
And it's 2,000 feet for missed approach altitude.
Yep.
1,000 feet, Barrow 320, visual, I have controls.
Amazing. That's the go around, yeah?
Yeah.
Ah, this is looking good. I think the ILS is probably on.
So auto throttle disconnects that one, isn't it?
Yeah, twice.
Okay. This is where it all goes wrong.
Yeah, remember, don't do very much, basically.
Yeah.
Gentle coaxing. You'll probably find it's much better now the elevators have been adjusted. You'll
yeah.
find it probably much easier to...
Yeah, flying it like a 737 is not really going to work.
No.
Decide.
Land?
Yeah. Gentle. To remind you, you're going to have no reverse.
Checked.
Lovely, mate.
Oh no.
That's alright, it's alright. We're there.
Gary,
yeah,
no reverse.
Reverse.
Yeah.
But yeah, you've got there's a turn off after this one.
It's he said roll
echo.
Past echo, right, manual braking.
He come off at echo though, is it?
Oh, is it here he wants
yeah,
us
here,
off?
Yeah.
Oh, excellent.
Okay.
So that landing was probably terrible, but
no, that was good actually. And you're just coming off here. There we go.
What was the rate?
I don't know. Tower, speedway 47, Charlie, just vacating via Echo.
There, main 220, nose 54, score 100%.
Really? Are you kidding me? Oh, excellent.
1216, thanks very much. Good night, 47, Charlie.
Most pleasing, as you would say.
That was most pleasing. Down to low speed of 47 charges with you, vacated Echo.
Speedback 47 Charlie. Ground bonjour. Taxi to gate number 3 by Alpha.
Gate number 3 Alpha. Bonjour, Speedbird 47 Charlie.
So. That Launch is.
Two.
I think it's this one here, is it?
No, it's beyond this gate, beyond this guy here. So it's. There's two air bridges, one and two, and it's the next one on the right.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I assumed there being three. Oh, there's two air bridges, yeah.
Yeah.
This is nice scenery.
Yeah,
it is actually. Unexpectedly nice scenery.
Yeah. Do I have to signal you to clean up or something?
Oh,
or?
Sorry, I just. Yep, subtle.
Right. Stand 3 is marked, I guess. It's
yeah.
No, that's stand 2.
Cabin crew doors to automatic and cross. No, manual and cross check.
Very tuneful.
I know, I thought so.
And the flaps are going to take ages to come up, aren't they?
Yeah.
Flaps primary associated.
APU.
Please.
The pitch trim is just electric, it's on the control column.
So there's no worry trim wheels in the 747.
It's very disconcerting for me, because you're used to putting trim in and hearing the instant response. So the tendency is to over trim, thinking that, oh, the trim's not moved because you can't hear it, when actually...
And there we are.
I think we'll stop here then, as you say. You can... We have to...
Do I do shut down now, or do I do that first?
Do that first.
Yeah, I thought so.
You don't... yeah,
I was
going to...
We have to wait till the flaps are all up, really, don't we?
Well, they're electric now.
Oh, okay. All right, you shut down 2 and 3 then.
Shut down. Yeah, that's why I did the hydraulic, because they're electric, the last bit.
Okay.
That's why they take forever.
Oh, so can we shut down?
We can shut down, yeah.
Okay, shut down 104 then.
I'm assuming, I think I've got that right, have I, Simon?
I think so, yeah.
Put that back to auto.
Because they would be air driven anyway.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
And the shutdown checklist, please.
Yes. Happy? I forgot to do those. Well done. Yes.
Sorry.
Okay, shutdown checklist. Parking brake.
Is set.
Hydraulic demand pumps.
Off and aux.
Fuel pumps.
Off.
Beacon.
Is off.
Doors.
Manual.
Fuel control switches.
Cut off. We've left one of the doors in automatic.
They're on the upper deck. But, oh no, entry one.
Entry one. Yeah. Okay.
Transponder.
Is off. 2000.
Seatbelt sign.
Off.
A car's pre-flight.
Cars
post-flight.
Post-flight, I
so
guess.
We need to just put Horgy in the landing pilot. Send. Work is done.
Sending. Right. That's it. Another sector down under the belt.
Oh, that's the cargo door just opened.
Oh, really?
Did you hear that?
Yeah, I did. A satisfying thump.
And you've got some external power available as well. But unfortunately, I don't think there's any conditioned air available in... KN.
Oh, should we just leave the APU running on pack one then?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. Excellent.
Right.
Easy. Thanks very much, everyone. Another pleasure. Thanks for a few donations there. That was good.
Decide Earthland.
Somebody's coming in a minute to fly to somewhere.
Yeah.
Hello, Fox Mike. Didn't see you there. Oh, and Tim Rodeo.
How often are you...
Ground, Aussie 121. Aussie 121, Cairn Ground, bonjour. Host position, there is a clear chat taxi from the right to the left.
Bonjour, Aussie 121.